Fair enough, but we're going to talk a lot about somebody you've watched on television for a long time with this important caveat and understanding about local television. Something that I know and that you know and that people in TV management sometimes do not know, and that is local TV, especially these morning shows, they're personal. If you grew up in Los Angeles, you watched morning TV for the last several years here, you know Steve Edwards. Steve had huge runs at Channel 2, Two on the Town, at Channel 7, opposite Christine, with a variety of shows there. KBC Radio, great afternoon radio show. Steve's done it all, and in 1995, in a huge pinch, Channel 11 called Steve up, asked him to take over a failing morning show, and due in large part to Steve's efforts, Good Day LA was, for a time, the number one show in the morning in LA. Fox has had a variety of management and budget disruptions. Good Day no longer has those great ratings, depressed ratings actually for many years. But still, everybody knows Steve Edwards. Yesterday morning at KTTV, just around this time, about 24 hours ago, in an all newsroom meeting, staff crew called together and told Steve would no longer be working there. Meeting tense and brief, and so frankly, also tense and brief, the announcement on KTTV this morning.
As we begin Good Day LA, we want to address what is being widely reported by other news outlets. We can confirm that Steve Edwards, longtime anchor of Good Day LA and a fixture on LA television for many years, is no longer employed by KTTV. We have no further information to share with you.
All right, now to developing news.
Oh, and Megan there, who is hired in large part because Steve Edwards said, that's the woman I'd like to sit next to for several years. And also, the two of them had just finished shooting a very extensive and expensive promotional campaign, a campaign that will no longer be used. We've not heard from Steve Edwards. We have heard from the TV news website FTV Live, who's reported that Steve's abrupt departure may stem from a sexual harassment charge. We don't know, and as you saw, KTTV isn't saying, we've not yet heard from Steve Edwards. Whole circumstance so abrupt, that may be no surprise we haven't heard from him. And maybe they should have shared this on KTTV, but they didn't, so we will. What about those who are working with Steve saying, Maria Cuban has done the weather there for years, and she posted this. Many of you have been messaging me about Steve Edwards. I don't know the details nor the circumstances of why Steve is no longer working with us, but I do know this. I've worked with Steve over the last 17 years. I've been at Fox, closely with him on the morning shows over the last 9. Steve, a mentor, a friend, and frankly, is family to me, and I have nothing but the utmost respect and love for him. Steve Holzer is a TV producer. He was the executive producer of Good Day LA until recently, and he posted this. I'm sure that the decision to let go one of the most popular figures in Los Angeles television was not an easy one. Just as I watched Nora O'Donnell and Gail King and Savannah Guthrie and Hoda Kotb struggle with their respective situations, I'm sure that the people who know Steve Edwards are struggling with this situation, myself included, and it just sucks all the way around. What of Dorothy and Jillian, who worked with Steve at the height of Good Day's success? Dorothy Lucy tweeted this, people keep asking the question. The answer is no, I don't know. And yes, I am shocked. Jillian saying Steve had nothing to do with her departure from the station. More answers than questions. KTTV could do a lot more, I suspect, to respect the relationship Steve clearly had with viewers. And as the Today Show and CBS This Morning have done, if there is dirty laundry to air it on their own air, or just offering more details, which they clearly know but don't want to share. Not everyone, though, is as supportive as some of the colleagues you've just heard from. The former KTTV reporter Suzanne Marquez is the entertainment reporter now at Channel 2. First, she posted this. I've never been fired, it's at the bottom of the page. I've never been fired from a job, a powerful colleague said with a sinister smile when he learned I'd been laid off. I guess there's a first time for everything. And then she added, this happened many years ago, and I've heard from several former colleagues who still work there who are thanking me for posting this. I see you. I remember what it was like. And for everyone mourning the loss of a person they admire, there are a lot of people with less power who stay silent for fear of losing their jobs in a highly competitive industry. I'm so grateful to be where I'm at now, working at a place where I have the most support I've ever had in my career. I'm so glad newsrooms are becoming a healthier place to work. So Suzanne's posting there is obviously generating a lot of attention and maybe shining light on another side that many people were not aware of. So we'll see. Again, I think it'll be very interesting. In the next day or two, do we hear from Steve Edwards or do we not? And what does that say or not say? Do we hear more from the station or do we not? So there we are.
All right.
Thank you, Sam.